T minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff of the Cassini spacecraft on a billion-mile trek to Saturn. Pitch program is in, roll program is in.
So one of the issues that they have had, you know, as the spacecraft did multiple flybys, each one at a slightly different speed, they're getting different concentrations of these different small molecules.
When that satellite hits that molecule, it basically disintegrates it. And it's very hard to know what you had if it's just its constituent parts.
So we're trying to get an idea of how they fragment and what the products might be. And I had a proposal into NASA that got their attention, I guess. We're trying to recreate those experiments in the lab by doing a high-speed impact of a molecule on a surface to try to see that fragmentation process. There aren't any easy ways to do that. So we're pursuing one of the easiest of the hard ways.
We're going to be having a rotor spin at between 1 and 4 kilometers a second, which is very, very fast.
So the Cassini had encounters up to about 18 kilometers per second. And there's no known way on the Earth to produce anything solid at that speed. And we want to get the highest velocity we can. So you imagine as it's spinning, the faster it goes, the more force there is pulling it apart. So we're literally running it just barely below the point where it flies apart. We have molecules that we introduce to the vacuum chamber. They're hit by this rotor, and then they are able to break apart. Understanding that process then lets us know what the original compound might have been.
It's nice to be a part of something that is so pioneering.
This is a type of reaction that no one has ever really explored before. So we're kind of exploring a new area in chemistry, and we don't really know what to expect.